Welcome back to Raw, this week brought to you by Foot Action. For every action, there's Foot Action.
And by Tiger Electronics, the makers of electronic laser tag.
Also by Jax. Collect Tag Team Series number one from Jax, available at most retailers. Well, you ready for that train wreck you're talking about, James?
I hear the engine starting right now. Because Kane once again emerged from his hiding place to wreak havoc in the WWF. And this time, Crush was the unlucky recipient. Crush not here with the DOA tonight.
His way to the ring with the rest of the nation. D'Lo Brown's going to be in action. You got to know that where there is The Rock, there is Stone Cold Steve Austin, and I suspect very strongly that we will see Stone Cold Steve Austin right here tonight.
That's right, and Rocky Maivia's got to be as nervous as a long-tailed cat in a room full of rocking chairs. Look, he's looking around. He knows Steve Austin is somewhere around here.
You might want to check that beeper.
He weighs in at 281 pounds, Miguel Perez.
Four men will be in this four corners matchup, but there's going to be a lot of volatile bodies on the outside as well.
That's right, it's going to be like mixing the elements of TNT and nitroglycerin. All kinds of dynamite, it could be an explosion.
And that's what we expect to hear tonight when Stone Cold, I gotta believe Austin's gonna come out here and open a can of you know what on somebody, namely The Rock.
Recon, the Truth Commission.
Well, the hits just keep on coming. Look at this guy.
Talk about weird.
This match is going to be D'Lo Brown versus Miguel Perez versus Recon versus Chainz. There'll be one man in each corner of the ring. Two men wrestle at a time. You can tag anybody. And when a man is pinned, submitted, counted out, or disqualified, he's eliminated. Last man in the ring will win the match.
And you hear this crowd with a very unflattering chant directed toward Rocky, The Rock. And The Rock, this Sunday on pay-per-view, will meet Stone Cold. You got to believe Stone Cold wants his property back. And it's going to be D'Lo Brown and Chainz, members of the Nation of Domination and the DOA. They don't like each other. Big foot by Chainz, a knockdown. There goes a D'Lo. And Chainz scores with another clothesline.
D'Lo Brown wonders what's going on. And now Chainz, that tremendous quickness for a man his size. Look at the way he sprints across that ring.
Great agility. Hostile, mobile, and agile, and there's a tag. And now I think, was there a tag? Yes, there was. And Recon now is in. Recon and D'Lo.
You cannot refuse to accept a tag. That's an automatic disqualification. You have to take a tag, even if you don't want to.
D'Lo counters and reverses Recon. Irish whip far side. D'Lo shows nice agility, misses the clothesline, and there's a hurricane run by the 6 foot six inch Recon of the Truth Commission. And when you talk about the Truth Commission, you got to start with that 7 foot interrogator. He's a monster and a half out here at ringside.
Look at the agility by Recon. It's tremendous for a man that size. And look at D'Lo Brown with the spinning heel kick.
273-pound CPA D'Lo Brown. I don't know if I'd want him doing my taxes, but that's another issue. Oh, catches a hard clothesline.
He refunded that one, and it makes a reluctant tag to Chainz.
And Chainz, by rule, must come in now and will face Recon as we look over the shoulder attempt to of the this huge interrogator. There's The Rock. Is there any escaping The Rock? We'll find out this Sunday on pay-per-view when Stone Cold and The Rock get it on at D-Generation X in your house.
Well, I'll tell you what, there's one thing that everybody out here has in common. They
that. Death Valley Driver. Chainz with a little assist from D'Lo. Just pins Recon. Now D'Lo's right back in. So the Truth Commission have been eliminated from this competition.
Ever an opportunist, D'Lo Brown now jumps on the chance. The Truth Commission is out, but they're not leaving. Look at that big foot by Chainz. You can see that right in the mush.
He went for the tag in Recon.
He got tagged.
And got tagged right in the jaw. And then in our Karate Fighters double feature, you saw the Death Valley Driver. So now there are three teams left by rule again. The Truth Commission should be leaving ringside.
But they're not going anywhere, and if you'll notice, there's one man that hadn't been in the ring until right now, Miguel Perez. The Boricuas are crafty. They're the smaller men, so they always pick their spots.
And Miguel now and D'Lo, Boricuas Nation, we've seen this guy. Oh, boy, what a chop. They've had some battles.
Whoa!
I'll tell you what. We are just the intensity, the whole intensity here in the WWF as we point toward this Sunday on pay-per-view is getting off the page. So good move there. There's a good move by Miguel. Can he hold it? Yes, he can.
He picked his spot. That's what I told you. He picked his spot, and the Nation has been eliminated.
Well, the Truth Commission hasn't left, and I don't expect the Nation to leave anytime soon. Wait a minute. Miguel is up. There's another Death Valley Driver. Crush has been dominant here. Crush has this match won. Here comes Savio Vega, or Chainz, I mean.
Well, wait a minute. The wreck just took place.
All hell is breaking loose here.
The brakeman has gone to sleep. Somebody forgot to throw the switch, and the trains are off the track.
Well, I tell you, we knew it could happen. It has happened. It's an all-out war here. The referee's calling for the bell. I have no idea of what the decision is, but Jacqueline's joining us here on headset. And why are you here? Why aren't you fighting?
I have an excellent vantage point from here. I can scout the talent. There's really no need for me to involve myself at this level.
Shouldn't you be over there right now with your guys helping in the fight, do you think?
Jim Cornette, do I look like an idiot to you? If I went over there, I could easily get hurt by a stray arm or a stray leg, and we know that my team cannot afford for me to be injured in any capacity.
Well, let me bring this up to you right now, Jackal. It appears that your boys are leaving along with the rest of the bunch, except for DOA, who's still here. I believe you're cut off from the herd.
I believe as long as I stay next to JR, a respected official of the World Wrestling Federation, everything should be just fine.
I wouldn't bet on it.
You remember what Steve Austin did to him?
There go your boys. Are you? I might want to trail along behind them.
I think I may just stay here and just observe the crowd for a moment. I'm looking for some new recruits.
Well, thanks for dropping by. Well, ladies and gentlemen.